Hello my friends, Johnny M here, and I'm presenting you a new episode in Farming Simulator 17 series on Canadian's map. As I often do, let me enjoy my beer while I'm watching and commenting this episode, and if you're over 18, I suggest you to do the same. If you're not, please enjoy a glass of juice or a cup of tea. So let's begin. This is supposed to be the second episode after my loss of my save files and my recovery of this series. So in the previous episode, if you remember, we seeded six fields, to be honest. So I think one with grass, two or one with canola, I don't remember, and the rest of them with wheat. And since then, I think we made two pigs deliveries and just one sale of sausages, which gave us about 4 million, but most of it, funnily enough, went on buying seeds and fertilizer for our 4 Borgold seeders. So now this, I think, is going to be the third delivery. Or the second, I may be mistaken. So, as I mentioned in my previous episode, that weird bug, which makes the crops mature faster, actually made so that the crops are already ready for harvest the second day. So instead of 2 days, which it should take with the slower speed, it for some reason took just 1 day to mature the fields. I'm still trying to figure out which mod or what caused this bug. As for now, as you see, I'm starting to harvest my fields. For the wheat fields, as usual, I will record the harvesting to load or bale the straw later. And in the meantime, I also decided to reseed all the fields left on this map with wheat, because after I recovered my save, all the fields, they were basically new and they had some crops on them, which I decided to ignore, because otherwise it would be cheating. So they all of them have withered, so I I don't like the visuals of withered crops, so I decided to go and reseed all the rest of the fields with wheat. Why all of them with wheat and some of them with canola or soybeans? It's because it's actually more difficult to harvest two types of crops in the same time, because for example canola and wheat have different crop yield, which means that the combines that are harvesting the fields with wheat will get full faster than the one crops that harvest canola. So this will make things more complicated. So an easier way to do the things on the map would be to harvest one crop at a time. So one time you harvest normal grain, being it wheat or barley, and the next time you harvest another crop like canola or soybeans. And I just started the mowing of my grass field, which I also seeded in the last episode. And it looks like not all the fields have withered from those that I have after rebuying them. But as I said, I'm ignoring the fact that they have something on them. And I'll just receive them. Let's see how much we get from this delivery of sausages. $3.3 million. That's because the sausages this time didn't have the best price. And as you can see, this time I have lots of things to do in parallel. I'm harvesting with four combines in parallel, and I have to serve them all with just one truck. And I'm also seeding the fields with four seeders in parallel. I'm also mowing a grass field. So yeah, lots of things to... At this point, this game becomes more like a management farming game. So I'm constantly monitoring my seeders, and if some of them finish their field, I'm setting them to reseed another one. Yeah, there is a problem with field number 12. For some reason, it doesn't have any crop on it, and also I cannot seed any crop on it. I don't know what's the problem and what's the glitch. It's the first time it happens to me. Maybe that's the version of the map, because I doubt that now I have the same version that I had previously. Because I don't remember where I took my map last time. So probably this is another version. And probably it's an older one. So not all the bugs have been solved. We'll be right back. So yeah, as I was saying, this should be the last time when I'm harvesting two types of crops, because it's too much to monitor all of them. And the thing is that there is no an easy way to monitor your combines, because after all, this is not a management game, it's a simulation game. So in order to really monitor them, I have to just go through all of my equipment, and it's quite cumbersome. There is this new farming management game that I wanted to try and maybe make a video on it, but I just seem to not find time to do it, because usually in the evening I'm just too tired to try another game, and I just do something easy, something I know, like Farming Simulator or Minecraft. Because that's the problem, as you get older, it's actually harder to adapt for new games and in general for new stuff. And if I were to do it, let's say, in the morning, then yes, it could be easier, but after a long working day, it's not that easy to get to immerse yourself into a new game. You usually want to do something easy and stupid and that you know very well. I honestly don't know if you can keep up with what is happening on the map. I wish there was a better way to visualize things, like how many workers you have, what and where each worker is doing. Because even for me it's quite hard when I'm doing it, but I guess for you, especially when it's speeded up, I hope you can keep up with it. If no, then let me know, and please tell me a better way to explain or to visualize stuff. Maybe there is a mod. I think there was some mods that were showing on the screen what the helpers were doing, so please suggest me something, because again, this is not intended to be a management game, although I'm using it more like a management game than a simulation one. So going through field after field as my helpers finish their fields. Some of them, as you just saw, leave immense patches of unseeded area behind. This is a strange glitch. I tried to reseed it manually, but it doesn't work. So lots and lots of glitches on this map. I think the The Giants map, the standard ones, don't have so many glitches. Although their biggest weakness, at least in my eyes, is their size. And I'm not sure, but I think since FS11 or so, all the maps are the same size. I don't know about FS 2009, probably the map was smaller, I don't know, but I think since FS 11 all are the same size, which is weird. Why are they not allowing us to, you know, to have bigger maps, standard ones? I mean. Ideally, as I think I said it a number of times, would be to have a random map generation. And again, this is not a technology that it's, you know, from the future. Because we had random map generation even in, for example, Age of Empires 1 from 1997. So even that game had random map generation. So why in 2017 we don't have a random map generation? I don't understand. Because it shouldn't be that hard. Look at these games like No Man's Sky that can generate a universe out of just, you know, a seed, and lots of other games like Minecraft, which can generate worlds, entire worlds, out of a seed, using procedural generation. Why can't FS series do the same? I don't know. I guess they could, but they just don't want to bother. Why bother if you have this mod fan base that makes all these amazing mods? Harvesting is almost finished. For the wheat fields, I'm saving the threshing courses. But I still have some fields to reseed. There is still field 21, I guess, that we can reseed. Yeah. Yeah, I think I mentioned this. This is a different loading wagon that I had. It's basically the same, but an extended one. So it's higher and it has a bigger capacity. So basically I replaced my old one with this one. As a small compensation for all the losses from my problem with the C drive. And just when I set that loader to work, I noticed that I forgot to modify it. So it's not tier 10, it's still tier 1. I will do it shortly, just right after finishing this harvesting. So I think originally it has 71,000 liters of capacity. I should make it 715, I think. So 10 times more for tier 10. And of course the harvesting of all the fields that we seeded today is going to happen in the next episode, because now we run out of time. As usual, thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, then give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you're new here. Also, if you have some advice or just anything to say, then leave it in the comment section below. I wish you all a great day and I hope I'll see you all next time. Bye bye.